quiet enough. Such arrogance. Take your pipe out. They'll be down that time for it.
Number of white supremacy.
We got here before Ranrok.
I can't believe this is it. The repository has been under the castle for hundreds of years.
Think of all the pain that created it. This is what Miriam, George, your friend Lodgok, and countless others died for. Miriam believed this forgotten magic could be used for such good. But she did not know the risks. She did not see what the Keepers have shown you. What Isadora showed you. You are now the Keeper of whatever power it holds. What do you intend to do with it?
I plan to leave the repository as it is.
I'm pleased to hear that. I've been thinking.
What is it, Professor?
I spent all year trying to keep our journey a secret from everyone, including Professor Weasley. But now I wonder if I should have shared it with her and the others sooner. Trusted them more. The Keepers wanted this secret to be locked away forever. How long will you keep it?
The Keepers were right. The risk of using this magic is too dangerous. It is my responsibility alone to keep it safe.
I understand, but you are not entirely alone. I will do all I can to help you.
God. The arrogance of wizard kind. Goblins built this repository. It belongs to us.
Enough, Ranrok. It was never yours.
I've been wanting to play with this.
Miriam's wand.
If she'd simply handed over the container, all of this could have been avoided. Foolish, self-important witch. Seems you are two of a kind. She didn't know when to give up either.
Thank you. harder.
Thank you.
sir.
Professor Eleazar Figg. I dare say he was a beloved professor to many of you, certainly a long-standing colleague to his peers. A famed adventurer and seeker of knowledge, he built a reputation charging into the unknown, brazenly disregarding both discretion and safety, providing perhaps a rather unfortunate lesson for us all. His devotion to adventure was rivaled only by his dedication to Hogwarts. And of course, to his wife, Midi, whom we lost much too soon as well.
Professor Figg represented the best of all of us. Oh, he could be deviously clever, possessed a brilliantly inquisitive mind, and was the most loyal of friends. But perhaps it was his remarkable courage, for which we will all be forever indebted to him. If not for Professor Figg, well, I can say with confidence that if not for him, many of us, let alone Hogwarts, would not be here today. Those that knew him best will agree that we must now honor him as only Hogwarts can, by wisely, resourcefully, justly and bravely facing all that lies ahead.
To Professor Figg!
I can't believe we lost Figg. I didn't know him as well as you did, but I know he was a good man. Glad Weasley spoke for him. She honored him well. Figg will be well remembered. I wish the same could have been done for my uncle. I wonder if there's a chance Anne would meet me.
Sebastian, I can't imagine what you and Anne are going through. Perhaps you'll hear from her soon.
I hope so. I'll let you know.
Sebastian, there's something you should know. It's to do with Victor Rookwood.
I heard a rumor that he confronted you outside of Ollivander's. Sounds as if he faced quite a fight.
The rumors are true, and I did. But it's not that. Just before Rookwood attacked, he uttered something familiar. The same words Anne heard before she was cursed. Children should be seen and not heard.
Wait, what are you saying?
It wasn't one of Ranrock's loyalists who cursed Anne. It was Rookwood. It was Rookwood all along.
This can't be. It was the loyalists. It's always been them. The night Anne was cursed, all she saw were goblins.
Once Rookwood allied with Ranrock, Isadora's estate became of interest to them both. That's why Rookwood was there the night Anne was cursed. He was working with Ranrock. When he saw your sister, well, he didn't want anyone to know.
So he cursed her, and she's never been the same. So cruel. Rookwood deserved what he got. Thank you for telling me. It wasn't a goblin. I suppose I owe you an apology. All this time I thought goblins were the enemy. But it was never that simple. Ominous said he's spoken with Anne. I wonder if she'll see me. I'll find out and send word when I know more.
Handy resource indeed, your field guide. I'm most pleased.
Thank you. Duncan owes his reputation to you.
I'm glad you came.
Sebastian, I've received your owl. What's happened?
Ominous spoke with Anne about what happened with my Uncle Solomon. She believes I should pay for what I did, but she won't turn me in. She said the guilt I'll have to live with is punishment enough.
I'm so sorry. But I'm glad you know that you can at least try to move on now.
The thing is, I think I've lost my sister, my twin, forever. She refuses to even see me. I can't blame her. I couldn't really blame any of you if you gave up on me entirely. You all believed in me, and I let you all down.
Anne may just need some time. Surely one day she'll be able to forgive you.
I hope you're right. I realize I can't undo what's been done, but I can try every day to make up for it. I owe you and Ominous everything for standing by me.
Well, it wasn't easy, but I believe in you, Sebastian. I've had a sense about you since that first day in Defense Against the Dark Arts.
Seems so long ago. Thank you. I have no idea what's to come, but I'm grateful for your friendship. I'm glad you came to Hogwarts.
Deke thinks you've made marvelous improvements here.
Revelio. Revelio.
You've made marvelous improvements here.
Hogsmeade, here I come.
Next thing you know, it's unforgivable curses.
You don't ever want to find yourself in the pocket of one.
Before you ask, I'm all out of the new sock, so if your feet are smelly, you'll have to work it out for yourself.
Ah, I'm afraid that's a little outside of your means, for now at least. I suspect you have a sharp eye for fashion. Be sure to stop by whenever you're about.
much as you know Luma.
How about some sightseeing? No need to race now, my friend. Time for a jaunt, I'd say.